Hello everyone, welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. Today I'll be passing over to Curtis McHale, who is going to be diving into Obsidian updates that have been released in December 2020. It's exciting to see Obsidian grow, especially as it reaches towards being out of beta, still some time to go. However, make sure to check out the Obsidian Made Simple course, which you will find in the link in the description. This is a full course in order to learn Obsidian from scratch, all the way to intermediate and some advanced lessons in there too. A big thank you to Curtis for coming on the channel. Please do make sure to check out his YouTube channel as well in the link in the description. On with the show.
Welcome. Today we're going to go over the updates for Obsidian for December 2020. This covers versions 0.916 to 0.10.1. First thing I want to look at is sync. So Obsidian now has end-to-end sync that you can pay for if you want. It's going to be selective. It has version history if you want. And the easiest way to find the details is to go into your settings, turn on sync here, check sync, and then you can see it tells me I have to purchase it. So we can go to all the ways that you can support Obsidian. You can see sync is $4 a month and has the end-to-end encryption, built-in version history, priority email support. That's it for sync. Next up, we have some stuff with front matter. One of the first things we can do is an alias in our front matter. So a front matter is defined by these three dashes, right? Three dashes. So everything inside here is front matter. And the aliases are, in this case, AI and artificial intelligence. That means that if I search, I can search AI. You can see it right here is Obsidian Testbed. It linked to that file, right? Obsidian. See, I have the file there, or I can also go artificial intelligence, and then I can define that in there. Now this takes what's called a YAML format. And so that is a programming language. That means you need to put the square bracket to define what's called an array, and then our multiple aliases here. If we wanted to have a fancy character in here, let's say we want to need a pound in here, we could do pound or a dollar sign maybe, something. Now we'd also have something in there, but we do not need, and actually it needs to be double quotes really. Double quotes instead of single, double quotes. So now we can have that alias as well. It would be something. Next thing we can do with front matter is we can also have PKM and hype. So these are two tags here inside our front matter. Originally, you actually had to have your double quotes and the pound symbol, and then it would be recognized as a tag, but they removed that in one of the versions here as well. So it was first introduced, and I think it was 0.916, and then later on before, in this meantime, it's been removed, so you can just list them both like that. You can also now collapse preview mode, or collapse your front matter there, and in preview mode, you can also have it collapsed or shown in preview mode. Another thing you can do with your front matter is if you go classes, you can actually set up CSS classes so you could style your thing or your notes. So we go CSS class, and then we can list our classes, right? Class one. And now we would actually have a CSS class on our file, which would let us define special styles for this note so that it could show up differently. So for me, I have a lot of book notes, and I could actually have all of my main book notes styled separately just to look a little different so I could tell them apart visually easily. Now we're gonna do the last two ones that are kind of in the front matter stuff. Together, even though one is PDF only, really. So in export to PDF, we have, this will now respect your show front matter settings, which is inside the settings of Obsidian. And it will also now, PDF, allow you to decide what type of printing you wanna do, whether it's letter, you wanna do it in landscape, how big your margins are, and if you wanna downscale it or not. So you have more settings for your PDFs, and they will respect whether you show front matter or not out of your settings in Obsidian. Now on the themes front, we have a few new things here. If we go into our settings, let me go to appearance and themes. You can see I don't have any themes here, but we can browse community themes. It takes a second to load this. And we can now have multiple themes installed and switch back and forth between them. This is actually one that I love. I really like this 80s theme, so we could use it. And I have dark themes only set. Let's just grab another one. Oh, let's use this one too. So that's a community theme. And now I actually have, you can see 80s neon, and I can switch live between them right in the middle of it, or in the middle of using Obsidian. Another thing you can do if you are into CSS snippets is you can enable CSS snippets. So we can open the folder. We drop our CSS snippets in here. And we can enable and disable them selectively if you want to dive into that. I generally don't dive into all this extra configuration because this is a tool for me to get stuff done, and mucking with it means I'm not getting stuff done. There's also an update on our third-party plugins. So we can go in, check for updates. There's no updates found. But we can browse and we can actually go through and like individually update one. So if I installed the tables and there was an update specifically for the tables one, then I could update that as well on my own, or the calendars is what I'm looking at, not advanced tables. So I could update individual plugins without updating some of the other ones if I didn't want to do that. Finally, maybe some of the biggest changes have been in our file window over here. There's just a lot of stuff we can do now. We can now do multi-select, so that can be with option where we select separate files like that, or we can do, right, if I select one and if I hold shift, it'll select all the files between. Now that is for option for macOS and alt for Windows. Another thing we can do to preview is if we hover over a file and then hold command on Mac, control on Windows, you can see it starts to preview the file. So this is a cycling Dynamo Hub, it's a cycling thing. Another thing we can do is if we want to go back to my test bed and if I want to search, let's search men here, and I can drag it in to create a link to a file now. That's new. We can do a lot more just dragging like that from our backlinks panel. If we open up our backlinks, we could drag in there. So there you go. Let's just pull in this. All right. So I now have a link in here. So this mentioned AI as just part of a link, and that alias matched up to the AI alias I had in here as well. So we can do a lot more like that, dragging from multiple panels to link things together. So that you don't have to actually type the whole link in. You can be searching through your backlinks, through other spots, and then drag them into your notes so that they show a link. Another interesting thing you can do is if we open, let's open drafts for me. And I can actually grab from the file explorer, take drafts, and I can drag in drafts. I can drag in my Dynamo Hub, and this is actually a link to go out to that note in Obsidian, so I don't have to go searching for it later. So this can let you create dynamic links between applications so that you have your data around for you. Another nice thing you can do in the drag and drop is you can, I'll go to my new road bike, and I can drag it into my starred panel up here, and it's now there. And for a while you've been able to just drag these panels around, so I can drag it in here. Now start is just in there. And I can remove it with a right click and click remove. That's it for the Obsidian updates for December, covering 9.16 to 10.1. A lot of good updates. I think my favorites are the aliases and the front matter stuff. That's the stuff that I'm going to use. I'm going to modify some of my base note templates to include aliases, to include the front matter, so that I can see it later. Down below, you'll find a link to the Obsidian course from Keep Productive. Thanks for watching. Have an awesome day.